Oh, the battery is so warm. It fell down on power. Oh, that's really warm. Let's try a different one. I don't think it's got the right, yeah, it's only a 20C rating, that one. I could do with being more than that. Let me go try another one of these. I don't know whether that's fully charged or not. Okay. Alright, so that was the conclusion, albeit a short one, of a Hover Things Flip 260 Maiden. I had to stop it just because it just didn't seem to have enough grunt to keep it in the air. I was running at about 75% throttle. The battery was getting really hot. This is the second battery I tried in there, same one as before. Same rating and everything, I should say, different battery itself. But yeah, 20C rating, 3-cell, 1800 milliamp, and it was just getting really warm. I was running at about 75% throttle just to keep it all in the air. The yaw was crazy. The settings of, I thought at the time when I did the wizard to set this up, there was nothing to specify whether it was a large multi-rotor or a small multi-rotor. So the options there were sort of limited. So its default values, whatever they are for all the equivalent gains or PNIDs, I'm not sure what they're called on here, but certainly needs looking into. Just the yaw of it, it was very, very twitchy every time you, I don't know, throttle, pitch, roll, any, I couldn't throw it around at all. It was enough just to keep it in the garden balanced. And so it definitely needs tweaking. I'll try it again, mess about with, see if I can find someone else's settings for the PNIDs and give those a go. See if I can find a similar spec to this one. They're all going to be a similar weight. This looked very vulnerable at the back. I had a few of those shaky landings there. It was just bouncing off the ground. I just couldn't get the throttle set up right. So that definitely needs moving. I don't think I've got anything better on rating-wise. I think I've got a smaller 1500 milliamp, possibly. I'm not sure what the C rating is of that, though, but definitely needs to up the C rating. It's still warm now. And so, yeah, the other one I've probably... probably wrecked that one. I might have caught it in time, but that is still really warm, and it wasn't really in the air that long, so I was drawing a lot of power out of there. So yeah, at least it flew, everything, wiring, everything held up. I didn't have a chance to check the FPV gear. I can check that on the ground, I suppose. It worked last time. I had it all off in the just in the wiring loom, not actually on the frame. It all seemed to work. I had the Mobius running on there just to get a bit of footage to see whether it's vibration free or not, so it will say whether I need to do a bit more work up front. I mean, it's quite loose anyway, so I'd be surprised if that's not jello free. So yeah, all in all, it seemed okay. I wish I could have put it into a bit of a forward flight rather than just a hover, because sometimes you're fooled into thinking just because it doesn't hover well, it doesn't mean to say it won't fly well. Just holding this position, sometimes they can be a bit dodgy, but once you get it forward flying around and about, they seem to go a lot better. All in all, any maiden that doesn't involve a crash and repair has got to be a good thing. It sounded nice, sounded like a little mosquito in the air. So yeah, I'm looking forward to exploring this one a little bit, and hopefully I can get it. You could not fly that FPV in its current state. It was just that twitchy. It was a very fine line on the throttle between all or nothing. So it was 75%. As soon as you drop below that, it more or less plummeted to the floor, and it really struggled to pick up. It just would not pull up in the air. So it'll be interesting to see whether a larger size prop, which is depressing because I've got loads of these 5x4s, I may have a 6-inch prop, possibly. I'll go rummaging around in my prop box and see what I've got there. I think it'll fit. Only needs what? Another inch on there. It'll be tight. No, that'll clear. So yeah, I'll just check the motors can handle a larger size prop, and I'll do a bit more revision onto the statistics of the motors with props, see which gives the best results, because I think I'm under propping at the moment. Apart from that, it lives to fly another day. Right, so here we are, my hover things flip 260. I've been doing a bit of testing over the last couple of days on and off, trying to work out what's going on with this thing. The battery life is shocking. It is maybe 2-3 minutes in the air, and I've already trashed one battery. I've run below the voltage. I think I've recovered it, but I have to wait and see. I have to do another flight with it and see how it goes. But it's just burning up 2-3 minutes flight time, and the battery's red hot, and it's down, and that's it. I have one good thing is I've managed to calibrate everything. Found a good site to give you a guide on how to set things up, and if you've got one of those potentiometer kind of controls on your handset, then you can pretty much dial up the gains until you get an oscillation on there. And it was just a good workout for it, a good, really good walkthrough how to do it. And I got it flying well. I mean, I was getting like a minute's flight to, well, I don't know, 2-3 minutes, 3 minutes maximum flight time out of it. And so in that time I had to try and do all the calibration, so I was going through batteries like I don't know what. Admittedly, the burst rate on the batteries, they were quite low. It was probably a 20C with a burst rate of 30, the ones I was using. I tried some smaller size milliamp batteries with a higher burst rate, but I was getting the same results. So I pretty much conclude that it is the props. I'm under propped with these motors. I looked at the spec of the motors, and it did say it would carry these 5-inch props, but seemingly not with this weight. I've looked into the weight. This thing weighs around, it's about 550 to 600 grams, I think. Closer to 550 than 600, depends what's on it battery wise. But the motors should have lifted off, but when I've looked into the specs of everything, I'm drawn more and more into thinking the fact a 6-inch prop is the way to go. These are a 5x4, so I'm thinking the pitch also isn't helping. The battery's getting red hot, the ESCs are cool, the motors are cool. It's just the battery's working too hard, and it's very difficult. Even though I got it set up quite nicely, it was still, I was on the throttle all the time, on and off, on and off, on and off, just to kind of keep it level. It just would not hold a true enough height. It was very erratic. Sometimes I hit a sweet spot and it would just hang there, and then all of a sudden, as the battery got hotter, it just drop out the sky, and you have to give it. It was more or less like a bouncing ball. So I'm pretty sure I've got ordered as well. I went ahead a couple of days ago, and I already ordered before doing some final testing on this. I had come to the conclusion it was going to be the props, and I had ordered a 6-inch prop, and they come from Holland, so the postage shouldn't be too long for them. I'm thinking maybe tomorrow or at worst the end of the week. And I also took time, I was going to make it a my own 3D printed. tray for the Mobius isolation tray, but they actually had one on their website and it was really cheap, so I thought, right, whilst I'm adding the getting the props, I may as well get the Mobius mount as well. Like I say, it did fly well. I'm quite excited about this. People are like getting 8 minutes, 9 minutes, 10 minutes, and here's me getting 3. And I was kind of excited at 3 minutes, to be honest. So yeah, some weird goings on with this one. I do have those other motors I can use on here, but I'm holding off using them more out of interest to see whether it is the props or not. I may as well wait and try the 6-inch props, and then if they don't work, swap these motors out and take it from there. Also, the video transmitter. I thought that was causing or draining a lot of my power from my battery, but I unplugged it, and even though I got slightly better flight time, I ended up damaging the battery, and it didn't really have much of an impact on it. So it wasn't the six, and every loads of people fly with this Immersion RC 600 milliwatt video transmitter, so I was thinking it couldn't have been that anyway, but I did unhook it from the power source as a final test, and it did make a slight improvement, but that also may have been the fact that I flew it too long on the battery as well, so not sure about that. I need to stash that as well better. I had a couple of landings when I came in, the battery was dying and it was just coming in tail heavy, and that really looked exposed on there, so that's not going to last very long. I've got plenty of room on that deck to push it forward, which I will do. I've seen a lot of people as well put the actual aerial antenna through this hole using like a cable extension lead. I've ordered one of those so I can push this whole apparatus and get it within the frame and just get it protected really. I don't know when that cabling, that's coming from China, it's one of those, so it could take forever, that thing. It arrives when it arrives, and when that comes I will strip this back down and do a few of the modifications. If the props come, I'll put it up in the air as it is, first of all, to see where I am with it, and then afterwards I'll get a few flights in it, but that definitely needs some modification to it, and also possibly I need to drop that distribution board. I've got that distribution board sitting on some cushioning, which is about 1 or 2 millimeters, and I could just do with that space for my wiring. I need to sort this out as well. This is very, I don't like the way it comes out, because especially when I get the larger size props, it's all very close to the propeller area. When the battery's on there, it's not so bad. The battery kind of pulls this out the way, so but any accident and any slippage and that thing is going to be clattering on my prop. So again, I've seen some people have routed it through these holes at the top. It might make it a little bit harder to work on, but if I use a thinner gauge wire down on here, then I'm pretty sure I'll be able to get it bent round a few corners and maybe popping out on the top deck through here, so that should hold it in place. Apart from that, I'm happy, sort of, the way it's now heading. I'm happy I've got it calibrated a lot better than the initial flights. Like I say, I haven't bothered to record any of the other ones because by the time I got my camera out, the battery's on the actual quad is dead, so it's hardly worth the effort of recording it for 1-2 minutes of flight. So